Welcome to Dunstan Kiwi Bred. I'm Alicia Nielsen and I look forward to you joining me over the next half hour as we take a look at what's happening in the New Zealand thoroughbred breeding industry. This week we're in Hawke's Bay to inspect the first season foals of blue blood stallion Niagara. I recently spoke to Lime Country Thoroughbreds Joe Griffin about the stud's newest arrivals. Joe, this time last year you were introducing Niagara to New Zealand breeders with a great deal of confidence. Here we are 12 months on. How's he come on since we last saw him?
Look, I guess like every second season sire, he's let down a lot. He is impressive. We took him up to the Karaka Stallion Parade. Really well received for a lot of people that hadn't seen him up there. And a couple of the other stud masters, some of the statesmen were very gracious, came over and had a look at him and said, you know, you've done really well, which as a young stud was really nice to hear.
Physically, he looks much stronger. How well has he developed with time to let down?
Look, I think he's always been quite a physical horse and a big horse. He just fills your eye now. You look at him and he is a big mammoth of a horse. I don't think anybody that has been to see him this season has not booked a mare.
Of course, his is a pedigree with enormous appeal, but what of the deeds of champion three-year-old Puccini and filly of the year Costa Viva, who share his same sire? What have they done for business?
Look, I think astute breeders have picked up that obviously both those horses are by in Costa del Lago. I went to Arion, I guess at the beginning of this month, and I said, how many three-year-old horses did Encosta have race in New Zealand for that season? And he had 7 3-year-old runners, of which we've had New Zealand Bloodstock Filly of the Year, and the champion three-year-old in New Zealand. Of the 7 runners, 5 winners, 2 Group 1 winners, and the other 2 have been placed, which is just a phenomenal result for any sire in any country.
Joe, we're very excited to see his first season foals. What are your impressions from what you've seen so far?
You know, you wait and you don't know what's coming out, but I think we've had 17 on the farm now, 3 others outside. Every foal has been bay from a variety of coloured mares, but Star, Snip, a couple of White Sox. I guess they've got a bit more bling about them than I was expecting, but you definitely walk into the paddock and you can even at this stage tell which ones aren't his from a long way off.
We're seeing a selection of Niagara foals here today, Joe. Let's start with, first of all, the Niagara Parole filly.
Look, Parole was a mare that we leased off her owner, and we particularly wanted a mare like Parole. She's had 8 wins. She won 8 up to 1,400 metres. We broke in a Zabeel of hers this year that Greg absolutely loved, and we leased her for 2 years. This filly foal, the breeder who owns the mare feels it's the best foal she's had, and she's asked if she can take her back and send her to Niagara herself this year off this foal. She's really muscular, got the bling, and very friendly and just a sweet type of filly.
You've also got the Niagara De Novo filly. Talk us through here.
De Novo, a bit like Parole, is only a small mare, and this filly is really leggy, good bone, muscular. She's another mare that we sort of are really pleased to have. She's a half-sister to Whanganui Guinea's winner and a horse that ran third in the Singapore Derby. Good result for the breeder.
From maiden mares, you've got the Niagara Peace Colt.
Yeah, he's only a couple of days old. She's a winning daughter of Emerald, and it's obviously the lovely Jennifer Rush family. Emerald won the 1,000 guineas, and it's just a champion filly family.
The Niagara Rosie Colt.
Yeah, this is an interesting one. The mare belongs to Windsor Park. She's a Thorn Park mare, out of a Mars K mare, out of a Sir Tristram mare. So they've looked at the blood that comes through and crosses really well. And it's a very good family, Starline's family.
Last year he covered a book of more than 100 mares. This year his bookings have come thick and fast. What do you put that down to?
Look, we questioned it ourselves, but I think at the end of the day, people have gone and looked for a physical type of horse to get them a good sales type or something that they can get up and get going early. And he obviously was a high-class three-year-old. I think that on top of Encosta's season that he's had in New Zealand, the massive result of a Tele Dispersal sale, which has just stamped his female family. We had 9 members of his female family sell in July for between $1.1 and $2.4 million. It is an outstanding family. We're very lucky to have it available at stud in New Zealand. And I think the New Zealand Bloodstock Pearl Series that we're getting behind this year, and all outside fillies that are born to Niagara, will be paying the nomination fee for. So that'll allow those breeders to race for up to $2.6 million in bonuses over 2, 3 and 4 year old years. And I believe we're the only stud that's doing that this year.
Joe, how would you describe the quality of mare that he's serving, and what crosses are New Zealand breeders pursuing with Niagara?
Look, we got some pedigree analysis done in Australia when we were originally looking for mares for Niagara. We've had a number of Sadler's Wells line mares, Sir Tristram Zabeel line mares, Last Tycoon. He has Dane Hill in himself, and we know Dane Hill and Costa cross really well. So if you've got a mare that you know crosses well with Dane Hill blood or crosses well with Costa, he's got that already wrapped in one. Mr. Prospector he's got in there. So as far as the calibre goes, this year he's got some lovely mares coming to him. Miss JDJ, who's a half to Kibbutz, Australian Derby winner. Maiden mare this year, laced up, half-sister to Jimmy Shoe. My First 15, half-sister to 60 Seconds, Spotswood. And then we have a number of half-sisters to Ellington, who's obviously the dam of Spilato, who's just won the Singapore Derby as well.
Time form ratings for Australasian three-year-olds over the last few years see Niagara sitting at 121. That's only a point behind Black Caviar and Northern Meteor. At $5,000 stud fee, he seems undervalued, Joe. Why have you positioned him there?
Look, I think being a young stud and a new stud, we needed to offer good value. We're outside of the Waikato and we needed to make it affordable. We know that you have to have numbers to succeed, and we've priced them accordingly that we've achieved our goal of getting the numbers we needed to.
It was a bit of a punt to import Niagara to New Zealand for the breeding industry, and a leap of faith for you and Greg to again stand a stallion in Hawke's Bay. Has the horse repaid your faith?
Well, look, the foals on the ground have been a huge relief, and the bookings that we're getting this year, he has more outside mares booked now than we covered all of last season. So he definitely has. Physically he's done it, the market's got behind him, the shareholders have been fantastic, and I don't regret it for a moment.